guys.
You want my carbon?
C2 to C4 carbon exists in gases state 2. C5 to C12 is liquid, and C13 onwards solid. For this also, boiling point is directly proportional to the molecular mass. Boiling point, melting point is directly proportional to the...
So is the even odd thing valid even here? The even odd thing for melting point?
Yes, that is also.
What is the...
Even things are more than all things.
Melting point is, has an irregular trend. It's not like it will increase with molecular mass.
Like so CED
is more than
70 and
C. It's because of the packing of molecule. More packing, more to the melting point. So melting point, like boiling point, does not have a regular trend. Okay. That's okay. With few exceptions. Then. Okay. Chemical properties, right down. The first reaction here. The addition of hydrogen. Right on. Catalytic hydrogenation of alkynes. Gives alkene first, which further goes under hydrogenation reaction and forms alkane. So first alkene and then alkane. Eventually you'll get alkane if you have sufficient hydrogen atom present. Suppose the reaction is RC, triple bond C, R dash. On hydrogenation, H2 with a catalyst, first it converts into an alkene, which is RC double bond C, RCHC double bond, HR dash. This further goes under hydrogenation reaction, and eventually we get RCH2, CH2 R dash, alkene. So alkene first and then alkane. This reaction we have already seen in the preparation of alkenes and alkanes, right? H2 with nickel platinum catalyst, what it forms, or addition of H2 with Na in liquid NH3. Two different reactions we have. This gives you Na in liquid NH3, gives you trans alkene. And this gives you cis alkene. We have discussed this.
Which one's birch and which one's other one?
We have birch reduction is different. It's not birch reduction. This one is birch. This one is birch. This one is Sabatier's hindrance reduction. H2 with Ni. See, we have discussed.
We discussed that alkene.
Yeah, this is alkene to alkane. It's alkyne. So alkyne se pehle alkene mein aayega. Alkene converts into alkane directly. Okay, because there is only one pi bond. Here we have two. So in the first step, one pi bond breaks, gives you alkene, and then it converts into alkene.
So if I give it enough energy, will it stick the alkene point?
No. It's not. If you have enough number of H2. Excess of H2, you'll get alkane. If it is only one mole, then alkene. Okay, next reaction, write down. Electrophilic addition reaction. In this, the first reaction you write down, addition of X2, halogens. Addition of halogens you write down. Generally, bromination and chlorination we'll discuss here. Write down addition of halogens. Electrophilic addition. Okay. The type of reaction is electrophilic addition. The first one is addition of halogen. Write down addition of halogen. Addition of halogen on alkynes gives 1,1. Gives 1,1,2,2 tetrahaloalkane. 1,1,2,2 tetrahaloalkane. This reaction involves a three-membered cyclic halonium ion. Which is very unstable. Strained ring forms, hence it is unstable. Okay. So overall the reaction is what? Suppose you have an alkene R C triple bond C R dash with X2, it gives R CX2 R dash. Two molecules. It is not the dominant number, this 1 and 2 position. Okay. So, you see in this, the intermediate step is this. RC, triple bond, CR dash, and this has a tendency to joins with, the halonium ion that is expressed. Like this, it forms. This pi bond won't be there. It forms a, we can write like this. Right, so three-membered ring. Now the point is, this cyclic three-membered ring is highly unstable because of high angle strength. Three-membered ring, high angle strength is there. So this is highly unstable. Second point is what? This pi electron, here the pi electron, is bonded with sp hybridized nucleus of this carbon atom. That's why this pi bond is strongly bonded to these two carbon atoms. And that's why what happens, the reaction rate is extremely slow. Okay. The reaction goes with very slow rate. Two reasons. One is what? Highly unstable intermediate is forming, which is this. And the pi bond here, it is connected to or joined with sp hybridized nucleus of the carbon atom, which is very, very, you know, tightly bonded there, right? The pi electron. That's why the tendency itself to form this three-membered ring is less, hence rate of the reaction is very slow, right?
But since it's sp, won't there be like a really large concentration of electrons, so the positive halide will like get pulled very strongly?
Right. Addition reaction takes place because of pi electron only. Benzene may be the same thing we have. Since the pi electrons are delocalized over the ring, right? Benzene ka ring suppose ye hai, this pi electron is continuously moving, right? Yahan pe bhi, yahan pe bhi. Because of this electron cloud only, any electrophile is directed towards this. So electrophile ka jo addition hai, that is because of the weakly bonded pi electron. Jo ki in general we say, because pi bonds are weaker than the sigma bond, right? But here what happens, if you compare alkene ka and alkyne ka rate of the reaction, okay? Alkyne mein the rate is extremely slow because the carbon atom is sp hybrid. See, these things are relative. Aisa nahi hai ki ye bahut slow hai, or means when we say that it is rate of reaction is very slow, it means in comparison to alkene it is slow.
Why is a halonium ion very unstable?
Because it's three-member ring. Three-member ring hai. So here we have very high angle strain. Three-member ring unhe padha hai na? Angle strain bahut zyada hota hai wahan pe. Because of that, this three-member ring is highly unstable and has tendency to convert into larger member ring, 3 to 4, 4 to 5 or something. Okay? So two reasons. First is this, and the second thing is sp hybridized carbon atom. The rate of the reaction is extremely slow. Hence, ये जो reaction है ये हम लोग किसी catalyst के presence में कराते हैं, which actually enhances the rate of the reaction. Okay? So write on this point, these two reasons you write down. The pi electron in alkyne, is bonded with sp hybridized carbon atom, which is strongly held by the carbon nuclei. Hence the rate of the reaction is extremely slow and usually the reaction is carried out in presence of a catalyst. in presence of the catalyst. Okay, so the product is what? Just this pi bond you have to remove and you have to attach to halogen atom onto this. It's step by step process. It is. Here also one thing you have to memorize, that if you take only one mole of halogen, then we'll take what? Then we'll have 1,2-dihalo compound we get with one mole of halogen atom. So suppose the reaction is we have CH triple bond, CH ethyne, and when this is allowed to react with Cl2, the product is CHCl double bond CHCl with one mole. This is the product. Again, if you add Cl2, then the product is CHCl2 CHCl2. Okay. Two-step process. Or if you directly write right here, excess of Cl2, then this converts into. Okay. Next point, write down. Addition of HX, halogen acid.
So it's under the
second reaction. First one is this. Addition of HX.
In this one
it is cis addition, same side. No, it's like it is anti, opposite sides. First we get that ring, and then opposite is Cl attack and the ring open. Okay, we'll get a ring first. See, actually this gives you Cl plus. Okay, and this pi electron will attack onto this. So this carbon forms a 3-member ring, and then the other Cl minus will attack from the opposite side in this group. It is anti-addition. Okay. Next, write down addition of HX. The reactivity of hydrogen halide towards alkene is this: HI maximum, HBr, HCl, and HF. Because of bond length, here the bond length is maximum, hence the dissociation is easy. Okay. Write down. This reaction follows Markovnikov rule. This reaction follows Markovnikov rule. Markovnikov rule.
So what about in the presence of peroxide?
Same thing, anti-Markovnikov. Everything is same. All these reactions are very similar. So the reaction of suppose CH triple bond CH with HI. Or if I write down CH3, C triple bond CH HI, what is the product we get in this two reaction?
So is there excessive HI or
just one?
Okay, so I'll write down excessive. Excess. Here also it is excess. What is the product here?
CH.
Okay, this one is right. Markovnikov. This one with HBr and peroxide. Done. Product is CH3, CH2, CH,
BR2. And here, if it wasn't excess, we'll get double bond.
It means it is excess. If it is not, then we'll get double bond. It is anti-Markovnikov. Peroxide is there. If it is not excess, then double bond. Okay.
So, but why both of the BRs attack on that same?
See, step by step, Bhavani, you get this CH3, CH double bond, CHBr, with one HBr.
Yes.
Now again, this one with HBr, correct? So which carbon is more substituted here? Which carbon is more substituted? Why this one? Why not this one?
That guy is attached to two carbon. This guy is attached to one.
This carbon has one methyl group and one hydrogen. right? This carbon has one hydrogen and bromine.
So, but what counts as more?
No, you see, Br- has tendency to attach, since it is peroxide, so this will attach on the carbon which has more number of hydrogen. Or if peroxide is not there, then more substituted carbon atom. Since it is peroxide, alkyl substituted carbon atom which you have is considered to be the more substituted one. Alkyl substituted. So this one is the less substituted and Br will attach at this carbon. Always you consider this, that whenever we talk about substitution at a double bonded carbon atom, it means alkyl substitution, presence of alkyl group at the carbon atom. Okay, so this is more substituted than this, product will be Br2 will attach at this carbon. Okay, in presence of peroxide. If it is not there, peroxide, then here we'll have CBr2CS3. Okay, next reaction, see, I'll write down one more thing here. Similar kind of reaction alkyne shows with HOX, okay, or if you take H2SO4, similar kind of reaction, or even if you have CH3COOH. You just need to find out the negative part of this reagent and the positive part. What is the negative part here? This is the negative part, OH minus, because oxygen is more electronegative.
So this follows the antimonic?
No, addition is similar to this. Antimonic is only for HBr. Is this the negative part will attach on more substituted carbon?
So but fluorine would be negative. That was
No.
No, even, yeah.
O-fluorine bond is not there. It is difficult to break that bond. So HOCl or HOBr generally addition reaction shows.
So that was fluorine, isn't HOF the only compound where fluorine has a positive thing or something?
Yeah. No, fluorine always shows minus.
So isn't there one compound? Like
that is, no, that is not. Oxygen has
yeah.
Oxygen is plus, this is minus. Yeah. Oxygen is plus, fluorine is minus.
So, but there's one fluorine compound, only one where fluorine has a plus.
I don't think so. Oxygen is the one compound here where the oxygen has positive charge, because fluorine is the most electronegative element. So it always has minus
charge. So would I remember there being one exception?
I don't remember. Exception is this. In this compound, oxygen atom is the only compound where oxygen atom has plus charge. I don't remember fluorine. We'll check something. Okay. So here, what happens if you have HOX? That HO minus and X plus will attach onto the carbon atom. In case of H2SO4, what happens? H plus and HSO4 minus. Here what happens? H plus and CS3 COO minus. All these addition takes place according to this. Okay, suppose my reaction is over. CH3, C triple bond CH with CH3COOH product.
So the HI, what is formula? H plus and I minus or H minus?
Which one?
So for HI?
Yes, I minus H plus. Yes. Br minus H plus. Cl minus H plus. What is the negative part of this reagent? CH3COO minus. So C O C double bond O CH3. Double bond CH2. You were in the first step. In the second step, what happens? Again, the same molecule. CH3COOH. So it forms CH3COC double bond OCH3. Here also we have same thing. So similar, exactly same pattern we have. CH3COOH, H2SO4 and HOX.
HOF.
Yes.
Yeah.